Hello and welcome to Deckheads, brought to you by Shark Tank Media. This is our first episode and introductory episode for Blue Moon Legends. I'm Frank.
And I'm Tim. So Blue Moon City was a metropolis where many fantastical factions lived together in peace and prosperity. The Night of Doom came and left the city in ruins. The Golden Dragon had fallen, the Holy Crystal of Psy shattered, and the Old King dead.
But Blue Moon Legends is a 1v1 strategy card game where each player controls a faction vying for control of the city. And to do this, they must gain the support from one of the three remaining dragons. And these dragons are fickle creatures that only value strength and will so choose the strongest faction.
The game itself consists of a series of battles, and depending on the outcome, the victor will attract one or more dragons to their cause. The battles are determined using cards, and each card has several important pieces of information. There are two numbers that indicate the card's power value for each of the individual elements, either earth or fire, not to be confused with attack and defense that a lot of other card games use.
Yeah, for each battle, an element is chosen, either fire or earth. Also on the cards, you have the name of the card, what type of card it is, character, leadership, booster, or support, as well as flavor text. Then, certain other cards have extra icons that give them extra effects, and also if they have a special ability, that text is also present on the card. What's interesting about the special text is that, or the special ability text, is that it's written to be read aloud. So when the card says you, it means the opponent, and when it says I or me, it's referring to the current controller of the card. Can be a little confusing at first, but after you get in the swing of things, it's pretty easy to follow.
Yeah. So the game begins with each player choosing one of nine different factions. For the sake of simplicity, we're going to stick with the most basic factions, the Vulca and the Hoax. Starting player is determined randomly, and in this case, we decided that I will go first. So we begin play by each player drawing six cards. At the beginning of my turn, I have a couple different choices I can make. I can either start a new fight or decline to start a fight. If I decline, I get to discard up to three cards and refresh them, and then the active player would pass on to Frank. So I'm going to start a fight. So I start by playing a character. I'm going to play Vulca. Vulca of the Vulca.
It's an O, not a U.
Yes, Vulca. Vulca and Vulca. So Vulca has a 5 power value in fire, so I get to choose an element that's the contested element. So obviously I'm going to choose fire because she has 5. Then I'm starting the fight, I'm not allowed to play any other cards, so I will just refresh up to 6 cards, and then active player passes on to Frank.
All right, so now that it's the beginning of my turn, I get to choose if I want to play a leadership card, which I don't have. So now I have to choose whether or not I'm going to engage in this fight, or if I'm going to retreat. And if I retreat, Tim wins the battle, and he gains the favor of one of the dragons. I don't want that to happen, and I'm not a baby. So I'm going to go ahead and play a character card. And you know what? I'm going to go ahead and play Nirwadis the Traveler. Now, Nirwadis only has a fire value of 3, which means that I don't quite have enough to meet Vulca. But because I didn't start the fight, I'm allowed to choose if I want to play one booster or one support card, either or. So booster cards are played on the active character, and they increase that character in some way, maybe give them an extra ability or more power. And support cards are played in the support area, and they persist no matter who your active character is. So I have a support card, and I'm going to go ahead and play the Trebuchet of Fear. Trebuchet of Fear doesn't have any extra effects, but it gives me an extra 2 fire, and these are additive. So now I'm up to 5, I have matched Vulca, and I'm still in the fight. I've already played one support card, I'm not allowed to play any others, and now I just refresh my hand back up to 6, and it is now Tim's turn.
So during my refresh, I drew a card that was a leadership card called Cataclysm. So at the beginning of my turn is when I choose whether or not to play leadership, and I'm going to do it. So Cataclysm says, now I may discard all of your active support cards except active protected cards. His one support card is not protected, so therefore he must discard his Trebuchet of Fear.
If it was protected, you would see a symbol right here of a little helm. Doesn't have that. Trebuchet just gets discarded.
So now I get to choose whether I want to continue the fight or the retreat.
I think you should retreat.
I'm going to continue, and to do that, I have to replace the character that is currently active. Now, if I didn't have any character cards to play, I would be forced to retreat. But I do have Flair, so I'm going to play Flair, and during my end phase, I may draw 2 additional cards. So that way, when I'm refreshing, I can add 2 more cards. Now, Flair only has 2 fire power, whereas his Frank is currently sitting at 3, so I can't currently win, but I have this booster card, which you play on top of your character, called Elemental Enchantment, and my total power increases to 6. So now Frank has to best 6 on his turn. So I draw 3 more, and then an extra 2 because of Flair's special ability, and active player passes to Frank.
All right. So, during my refresh, I also happen to draw a leadership card, but this one allows me to play as many support as I would wish, but I don't have any other support in my hand, so I'm not going to play it. So now, I have to play a new character card if I want to continue the fight or retreat. Looking at the characters and other cards I have available to me, I'm not going to be able to best 6 power, so unfortunately, I have to retreat. By retreating, we both have to discard all of our active cards. So even if my trebuchet had not been destroyed, it would be going in the discard now. And because Tim only had 3 cards, and that's less than 6, he only attracts the favor of 1 dragon. Ah, Doran, the dragon of Earth.
Yes.
So that ends that battle.
Yeah, and if had I played 6 or more cards that ended up getting discarded, or 6 or more cards that were in the active area, I would have been able to attract 2 dragons. Now, let's just say Frank wins the next battle and that he plays 6 or more cards, so he would get to attract 2. But it's not quite as simple as saying, okay, these 2 are mine. First, he has to attract the one that is currently in my favor back to the center of the board, and then for his second dragon, he attracts 1 to his side.
I'll take Liza, the dragon of fire.
So before that, I had the favor of the dragons, and now Frank has the favor of the dragons. So the game ends in one of a couple different situations. One is if one player has all 3 dragons and then is in a position to get a 4th dragon, the game immediately ends and they win. Alternatively, if a player runs out of cards, then the game ends. However, if this happens in the middle of the battle continues to its completion. And after that, the game ends and whichever player has the favor of the dragons wins. However, let's say all 3 dragons are on the board and neither player has favor and the one player has run out of cards, then the player that ran out of cards is considered the loser, and if both players did, the player that ran out of cards first is considered the loser.
Yeah. So there are many other exciting aspects to this game, such as the other factions, deck building, and you know, a multitude of interesting effects. But we hope that this brief introduction is enough for you to be able to sit down and play, or at the very least enjoy Tim and I as we play our games of Blue Moon Legends. As always, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time on Deckheads.